It was winter time on Sodor and Christmas was coming soon. Everyone was working and posting letters to Father Christmas. One morning, the Fat Controller came to see his engines.
There's going to be a delivery of Christmas trees arriving at the docks from the mainland. Thomas, I need you and James to collect them and take them to every place on Sodor.
Yes, sir! Can't wait!
We're ready to get to work.
The rest of you will do your usual jobs, and Toby will take care of Annie and Clarabelle.
Everyone got to work. Thomas and James went to the docks and they saw the wonderful trees. Salty, Porter and Cranky loved Christmas too.
Take care of those trees. They are very special, me hearties.
Best time of the year.
I agree with Cranky.
Let's go, James.
Bye, you two.
Thomas and James were puffing through the countryside. They delivered the first trees, one to the farm, one to the bakery, and one to the dairy. And then they went to the Blue Mountain Quarry, the miniature railway, and Knapford Station, and pretty much every station on Sodor. Especially Bob's building yard.
Thank you so much, Thomas and James. This tree is brilliant. You're really welcome, Scoop, and the last stop will be Timber Sheds.
Get there safely.
We will, Bob.
Bye, everyone.
Thank you so much.
Yeah, it's amazing. I love it. Oh, so do I.
While Thomas and James were heading back to Tidmouth Sheds, it was starting to get cold and windy, but they didn't give up. Until suddenly, something went wrong.
Thomas, something's wrong.
Never mind that, James. We must keep going.
We mustn't give up. Ah.
What Thomas didn't know that the brake fan was shaking, the coupling snapped and it ran away.
Oh no!
Thomas and James stopped. Then the tree fell down.
The tree has fallen down. Oh no! What are we going to do?
Oh dear, what happened?
Our tree fell off because the brake van ran away.
It's my fault I didn't listen to James.
I'm really sorry.
Accidents happen, Thomas.
James is right. I'll go and get some help.
Soon, Ryan and Phillip got Rocky to clear the mess and he managed to get the tree back on the truck. Nia came and brought the brake van back.
I found this brake fan and I believe you need it.
Thank you, Nia, and thank you everyone for your help.
We need to get this tree to Knapford.
Good luck!
Get there safely. Thomas and James didn't give up.
Soon they arrived at Titmus' shed, and the others were delighted to see the tree delivered safely.
What a beautiful tree!
I love it!
So do I.
I couldn't have done it without James.
I'm always happy to help, Thomas.
This Christmas will be lots of fun.
I agree with Percy.
Soon the tree was put up, and all the engines thought this Christmas would be wonderful.
Next day, Bob and his machines, including Donald and Douglas, woke up and were waiting for Bob to tell them what to do.
I found out Christmas is coming up. I wonder what Bob wants us to do.
I have no idea, Donny.
Morning, team.
What's going on today, Bob?
Well, I got a phone call from the Fat Controller. He said that an engine will be delivering some decorations for the Christmas tree, but we have some jobs to do.
Scoop, I need you to go to the Blue Mountain Quarry.
Muck, I need you to go to the Miniature Railway.
Donald, Dizzy and Roley, I want you three to work with Bash, Dash and Ferdinand here because they want to learn all about you and our team.
Lofty, me, you and Douglas need to go to Bantry Station as they need the place to be decorated.
Can we fix it?
Yes, we can!
Yep, I'm with you all there. Bye!
Right, you two, let's get to work.
Now, you three, this is going to be simple.
Watch Riley and I do what we do.
Yeah, you'll love this.
Amazing!
We agree! Thank you very much!
Yeah! Do you think it's groovy?
Oh, absolutely!
I agree with Ferdinand! So do I!
We're glad to hear that! Soon Muck arrived at the Arsair Railway where he met Rex, Mike and Bert.
Hi little engines! My name is Muck!
Pleasure to meet you, Muck.
I'm Mike.
I'm Rex.
And I'm Bert.
I hear you're from Bobsville.
Oh, yes I am.
We need a dumper to help us with all this work. Do you think you can do that?
Sure I can. I'm ready to help.
Thank you very much. Watch how I shunt those trucks. Whilst Muck was working at the Arsair Railway, Scoop went to the Blue Mountain Quarry to meet the narrow gauge engines.
Hi little engines, my name is Scoop.
A pleasure to meet you. I'm Falcon,
I'm Rusty,
and I'm Rheneas.
And I'm Tony the Crane.
Wow, you're as big as Lofty.
Who's Lofty?
Oh, he's a friend of mine.
He sounds like a nice crane.
I'm orange, and what colour is he?
He's blue.
Ah, oh, lovely.
Anyway, I'm here to show you my digging tricks. Do you want to see?
Oh, yes, yeah, sure.
Right, I'm on it.
That was very impressive, Scoop. Thank you, Rusty. I do my best.
Phew!
job done.
Boy, that was loads of fun.
I agree. I'm certainly glad I had you two to help out. I think we need to get back to the yard because the delivery is due. I'd better tell Scoop and Muck.
It was fun working with you, little engines, but I think I need to go. Bob needs me back at the yard because we have Christmas decorations being delivered.
Bye, Muck.
Bye, Muck. Nice to meet you. Come again soon. I will. Bye.
Soon, Scoop and Muck came back to the yard.
I hope the decorations will be here soon.
Oh! Toby, there you are.
Are these the decorations?
They sure are, Bob.
Hello, Donald, Douglas.
Hi, everyone.
Oh, hi, Toby.
Oh, hello, Toby.
Thank you, Toby. I'll unload them to decorate our tree.
I'll watch, Bob.
Thank you.
Looks beautiful. The machine said thank you to Toby. Then he said, "Anytime, I must go. Bye." Everyone all together agreed that this will be the most wonderful Christmas they'll never forget.